southern and eastern Kentucky. This is WYMT Mountain News at 5:30.
Good evening, I'm Steve Hensley. The number of new COVID-19 infections has dropped 65% in the past 2 weeks. And recognizing that the nation is exhausted by the pandemic, the Biden administration is telling most Americans they can start leaving their face masks at home. CBS's Naomi Ruckham has the story and how people are reacting.
Looking ahead to the next normal, the Biden administration is loosening mask-wearing guidelines for most Americans.
We're in a stronger place today as a nation with more tools to protect ourselves and our communities from COVID-19.
The CDC says it's switching to a new metric to determine when face masks are recommended in indoor public settings, depending on COVID-19 case counts, hospitalizations, and hospital capacity. The most recent guidelines recommended masking for roughly 95% of the country. With the new policy, it's now closer to 30% in areas with a potentially high burden on healthcare systems. Even though most Americans will now be able to shed their masks, here in New York, that might take some getting used to.
I've got my mask with me, and I'm going to be wearing it in the grocery store and going to the museum.
I think it just kind of depends on the place and the amount of people and, you know, how safe I feel in that environment.
The shift comes as a new Lancet study confronts the tragic toll of the pandemic. More than 5 million children worldwide have lost a parent or caregiver to the virus, which explains why this Los Angeles restaurant owner plans to keep masking.
I have a young one at home. My chef is having twins on the way, so we want to protect ourselves as much humanly possible.
The administration's newest roadmap says COVID-19 is here to stay, but may join the ranks of other viruses, like the seasonal flu, continuing to threaten lives, but without throwing the nation into crisis. Naomi Ruckham, CBS News, New York.
Cold air filtering into the mountains as we head into the nighttime hours. It's been a chilly day today, and many of us are going to fall into the 20s and 30s as we head into the overnight. Outside right now, I-64 at Moorhead. The overcast continues. The good news is we're not seeing any more rain out there. Mountain Parkway at Slade still seeing some pockets of maybe damp road there, kind of in the middle, but otherwise looking okay. We remain chilly. Low to middle 30s around the mountains right now. Moorhead and Williamsburg both checking in at freezing and still in the middle to upper 30s. And in some other parts of the mountains, the further south that you go, it's northwest winds bringing in the chilly air. Satellite and radar, yeah, we had a few of those flurries a little bit earlier on today. Can't rule out a few more as we head into tonight, but it's mainly going to be dry as we see plenty of cloud cover continue to work through the mountains. So down into the upper 20s tonight, we'll try to clear out to partly cloudy skies, but I think some areas may have a tough time of that. I'll have the very latest on when things start to warm up again coming up in just a few minutes. Steve?
Evan, thank you. The trial against former Louisville Metro Police Officer Brett Hankinson resumed for day 3. Hankinson is charged with 3 counts of wanton endangerment for the shots he fired in the neighboring apartment during the raid at Breonna Taylor's home. The prosecution continues to call witnesses to the stand. The jury went out to Taylor's apartment, but before they did, they heard from the FBI, who said they conducted their search in June, 2 months after the raid. One agent said they took drywall apart during their search.
That's not something that we commonly do, but for this search specifically, we were looking for other items of evidence that may have been inside the wall.
Hankinson's defense claims he started shooting, thinking the officers were being attacked by what sounded to him like an AR-15. Kentucky will soon get millions of dollars to fight the opioid epidemic. Johnson & Johnson and opioid distributors have finalized a $26 billion national settlement. J&J and 3 opioid distributors will soon pay Kentucky $483 million for their role in creating and fueling the opioid epidemic. Attorney General Daniel Cameron says the money will go towards treatment, prevention, and education.
It's time to get real dollars in the door to heal our communities that have been ravaged by this poison.
Judges say this money could even help repeat offenders, pointing out that many inmates struggle with drug addiction. Today, President Biden held a phone call with Ukraine's President Zelensky for more than 30 minutes as enemy forces move closer to the capital. The Biden administration now says it will join Europe in sanctioning Russian President Vladimir Putin. U.S. officials and members of Congress fear that if Putin succeeds in Ukraine, then he could turn his sights to other former Soviet countries. Congress is debating two pieces of legislation that could help address the nation's issues with our supply chain. U.S. Secretary of Commerce Gina Raimondo says the pieces of legislation focus on boosting our nation's productivity on a global scale. Raimondo is calling on federal lawmakers to work their differences out and take swift action in the bills. She points to the global chip shortage as a reason.
20 years ago, we produced almost 40% of all the world's semiconductors. But over the years, that has declined from that to now we produce only 12%.
Lawmakers say the pandemic helped expose our nation's heavy reliance on other countries for goods. President Biden made history as he introduced his Supreme Court nominee today, Judge Ketanji Brown Jackson, the first black woman chosen to serve on the nation's highest court. The 51-year-old federal appeals court judge is a Harvard Law School graduate who was a law clerk for Justice Stephen Breyer, the man she will replace if confirmed. Senator Mitch McConnell released a statement on the SCOTUS nominee saying, quote, "I congratulate Judge Jackson on her nomination. I look forward to meeting with her in person and studying her record, legal views, and judicial philosophy. I also look forward to carefully reviewing Judge Jackson's nomination during the vigorous and thorough Senate process that the American people deserve." McConnell also pointed out that he voted against confirming Jackson to her current position less than 1 year ago. Tomorrow marks 10 years since Trayvon Martin was shot and killed in Florida by a man who claimed the unarmed teenager was acting suspiciously. The shooter, George Zimmerman, a neighborhood watch volunteer, confronted and shot the teenager, claiming self-defense. Zimmerman was ultimately acquitted, sparking both outrage and a renewed national conversation about race. Sabrina Fulton, Trayvon's mother, says time has not healed her wounds.
When you lose a child, that's a tragedy for you. You know, it's long time healing, it's long time grieving, and you just can't imagine just being complete anymore.
Trayvon Martin was just 17 years old when he was killed. A study finds transgender or non-binary youth suffer fewer mental health problems during their first year of gender-affirming treatment. It found adolescents and young adults treated with puberty blockers or gender-affirming hormones had 60% lower odds of moderate or severe depression and 73% lower risk of committing suicide. The research involved 104 transgender or non-binary youth, making it one of the larger studies to examine the impact of gender-affirming treatment on youth. Earlier studies have shown transgender youth have high rates of anxiety, depression, self-harm, eating disorders, and suicide. All you dog people, cat people, and if you've got a ferret, a fish, or even a red-eyed crocodile skink, you're in luck. Having a pet bestie could boost your brain power. A new study shows it could delay memory loss and other kinds of cognitive decline, especially verbal memory, like memorizing a list of words. For example, all the crazy nicknames you come up with for your pet. Now you can't just get a fish and bam, you're like Russell Crowe in A Beautiful Mind. Study authors say you've got to have a pet pal for 5 years or more. The big question, of course, is why? There's no clear answer from this study, but previous studies have shown the negative impact of stress on the brain, and pets can help you cut back on stress. And yes, that even includes cleaning up after them. Coming up on Mountain News at 5:30, one woman's journey to remember soldiers from the past takes her to a little-known cemetery. We join her mission in the mountains.
And cooler air continues to filter into the mountains as our cold front marches east. I'll have the very latest on the way.